Hello friends, today I'm going to discuss about Lau photographic method. It is a type of X-ray diffraction method, and these X-ray diffraction methods are categorized into four categories. First one is Lau diffraction method, second one is Bragg's method, third one is rotating crystal method, and the fourth one is powder method. So in this video I am going to discuss about Lau photographic method. So here first I will draw the diagrammatic representation of the same. This video is sponsored by GPAD Discussion Center. Visit GDC for GPAD.com for details about GPAD, NIPER, Drugs Inspector, and Pharmacist exams. Use Dr. Puspendra Classes coupon code, that is PK25, and get 25% discount in all online test series of GDC for GPAD.com. So this is the graphical representation of Lau photographic method. Here you can see that we have placed one crystal sample. Here one pin hole is there, very small hole is there. So incident X-ray beam will go towards the sample through this pin hole. Then this X-ray will be transmitted. Some part will be diffracted and some part will be reflected. According to this diffracted and reflected beam, this Lau photographic method is carried out. Now coming to the first point of this Lau photographic method. So as per this point, a small crystal which is sample is placed here in the path of narrow beam of X-ray. This is the X-ray beam from a tungsten target at about 60 kilovolt. It means this X-ray beam is coming or generated from a tungsten target and it is operated at around 60 kilovolt. Now this X-ray beam will pass through a pinhole collimator and it will give the sharp X-ray which will go towards the crystal or go towards the sample. So finally, as it is written here, this sharp beam of X-ray will go towards the sample to be examined. This sharp beam will go towards the sample. So there may be three mechanisms. First one is that some part of this X-ray will be transmitted, some part of this X-ray will be diffracted, and some part of this X-ray will be reflected. So according to this diffracted X-ray and the reflected X-rays, we are getting two methods of Lau photographic method. First one is diffracted X-rays, which gives transmission method. And second one is reflected X-ray, which gives back reflection method. So coming to the first one, that is transmission method. So in this transmission method, photographic plate is arranged on a rigid base. This is the photographic film which is arranged on a rigid base, and diffracted radiation will strike the film and recorded in the photographic film. So this diffracted radiation will strike this film and it will create a specific pattern which is known as Lau pattern of spots. And this Lau pattern of spots will be visible like this. So here you can see that this is the Lau pattern of a simple cubic structure, and this is Lau pattern of spots. These are spots. And here in this Lau pattern, you can see that one center spot is present because this transmitted radiation will create a center spot in this photographic film. So this is due to transmitted beam. Now here we can calculate the value of theta, and from that theta value we can estimate the distance between two planes. So this is the details about transmission method. Now coming to the second method, that is back reflection method, and that is due to the reflected X-ray, this reflected X-ray. So one film will be present in this base. So if we are talking about back reflection method, then it is used for large and thick specimen where this diffraction will not be possible. So in this back reflection method, we are getting reflected beam which will strike the photographic film, and it will create a Lau photographic pattern just like this. So here pattern will be created due to this reflected beam. So this is the details about back reflection method. And in this Lau photographic method, the size of crystal is larger as compared to other method. This is the major disadvantage of this method. And if we are talking about this method, then it is used to orient solid state experiment and to determine the single crystal symmetry. So this is the complete detail about Lau photographic method. Now in my next video, I will discuss about Bragg's X-ray spectrometer method. Thank you.